How are you doing today? I see you're already having a great time this holiday. It's time to fellowship with God. And as always, I'm always excited to be in your space. I'm sure you are too. There's a lot coming to you. Praise, nuggets, and of course the truth, God's word. Just sit back there and enjoy God's presence. Before we dive in, let us pray, as always. In Jesus' name, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this privilege and opportunity to be in your presence. We pray that as we learn from you, that you give us the grace to let your word come alive in our hearts, and we will manifest your glory all the days of our lives. And we promise to give you back all the glory in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise was fun and exciting. I'm sure you had a great time. Now it's time for Nuggets. And in this month of August, we've been taking you through the books of the Bible. And our topic today is Know Your Way Around the Books of the Bible. Do you know your way around the Bible with the books we have done so far? Last week, we ended with the book of history in the New Testament, Acts of the Apostles. For this week, we are starting with the letters written to the early churches by Apostle Paul. They are 13 in number. They are Romans, Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians, Timothy, Titus, Philemon. Now there is a song to enable us remember them. Listen and learn it.
Romans, Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians, Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrew. Romans, Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians, Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrew.
There are other letters after this. Immediately after the letter of Paul to Philemon are other letters written by other disciples of Jesus. They are James, Peter, John, and Jude. After Jude is the very last book of the Bible. It is a book of prophecy called Revelation. Now let us learn some facts about the Bible. Number one, God's word is perfect, sure, right, pure, clean, true, sweet, enduring, precious, trustworthy, and reviving. Number two, the Bible is the story of God and His love for us. Number three, whenever you're reading the Bible, God is speaking to you. Number four, the promises of God you see and read in the Bible are for you. And lastly, number five, as you read the Bible every day, you will know how God speaks, and the devil will find it difficult to lie to you or deceive you. Now enjoy the rest of the service.
Welcome. Today is chat room. Chat room is a time when we answer questions that you have. It could be questions on any topic. Anything that you don't understand that you would like to get clarifications on. But particularly, we answer questions concerning the topic we have taught during the month. This month, we've talked about the promised friend. And we said the promised friend is the Holy Spirit. Now, there are some questions here that we would like to answer. Lady Laurentia, the first question says, why can we not see the Holy Spirit?
Okay, we cannot see the Holy Spirit because He is spirit. Just the same way we cannot see God, we cannot see the Holy Spirit. Secondly, you cannot see the Holy Spirit because He is in you, right inside you. Now, talking of the Holy Spirit, the Lord Jesus said in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 16 to 17, I'll read quickly, and I will ask the Father, and He will give you another advocate who will never leave you. He is the Holy Spirit who leads you into all truth. The world cannot receive Him because it isn't looking for Him and doesn't recognize Him. But you know Him because He lives with you now and later will be with you. When the Lord Jesus told His disciples this, the Holy Spirit was with the disciples. Then on the day of Pentecost, 50 days after the Lord Jesus returned to heaven, He sent the Holy Spirit not to only be with all His disciples and followers, but to also be in them. And since then, once anyone gives his or her life to the Lord Jesus, the Spirit comes into the person and begins to guide the person. So, I hope
that's
you understand.
Beautiful. That's beautiful. That's very so. In other words, you're saying we can't see the Holy Spirit because the Holy Spirit is God.
Yes.
And the Holy Spirit is in them.
Yes, it is
beautiful.
In you.
That's great. That's great.
Okay, question two, Lady Uche, you help us with this one.
Okay.
How do I know that it is the Holy Spirit speaking to me?
How will I know when the Holy Spirit is speaking to me? Let me ask you a question. How do you know when your mom is speaking to you? You recognize her voice, don't you? That is the same way it is with the Holy Spirit. You must have to know His voice, recognize His voice, for you to know that the Holy Spirit is speaking to you. Now, how do you recognize His voice? You recognize His voice first by knowing the Word of God. Let's look at this scripture, John chapter 16, verse 13 to 14. It says, "When the Spirit of truth comes, He will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on His own, but will tell you what He has heard. He will tell you about the future. He will bring me glory by telling you whatever He receives from me." So what does this mean? It means that when the Holy Spirit is speaking to you, He's going to tell you things from the Word of God. Whatever the Holy Spirit is telling you has to be in line with the Word of God. So whatever you're hearing, whatever voice you're hearing that isn't in line with the Word of God is most likely not the Holy Spirit. So to know that the Holy Spirit is speaking to you, you have to first spend time in the Word of God. Spend time with God in prayer and in reading the Word of God. That's how you become familiar with the Holy Spirit and you begin to recognize His voice.
Okay, so what you're saying is, how much of God's word you know
will
determine how specifically you are able to detect,
recognize the voice of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, that's exactly. Amazing.
Great, Lady Laurentia, this question, it says, should I pray to the Holy Spirit?
You should pray to God the Father. In the name of God the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, through the help of the Holy Spirit.
Okay.
In other words, you cannot pray to the Spirit the same way you pray to God the Father.
Okay.
But you can ask the Holy Spirit questions and He will guide you.
Okay.
You can ask Him to guide you. Even when you pray, you can ask the Holy Spirit to help you to pray. Okay. But you cannot pray to the Holy Spirit.
Okay, so we don't pray to the Holy Spirit. We pray to God with the help of the Holy Spirit.
Right. Okay, Royal, now we've come to question number 4, and Lady Uche will help us answer this one. Question number 4 says, can I thank the Holy Spirit for helping me? And how can I do that?
Beautiful. Yes, you can. You can thank the Holy Spirit. In fact, you have to relate to the Holy Spirit as your friend. If your friend helps you do certain things, wouldn't you thank them? So you just say, thank you, Holy Spirit. Like, I will thank you, Lady Laurentia. It's that simple. You don't have to do anything special or extraordinary. Just tell Him, thank you, Holy Spirit. And another way you can thank the Holy Spirit is by doing what He asks you to do, obeying His instructions. When you obey Him and you do the right things always, He's pleased with you. In fact, God gave Him to us so that we can rely on Him and depend on Him and talk with Him and thank Him. You know, there's a scripture. Let's look at this scripture. Luke chapter 12, verse 11 to 12. In Luke chapter 12, verse 11 to 12, it says, "Now, when they bring you to the synagogues and magistrates and authorities, do not worry about how or what you should answer or what you should say, for the Holy Spirit will teach you in that very hour what you ought to say." So we have an inner alliance that helps us in any kind of situation. And we just have to say, "Tell Him, thank you."
I hope you won't forget. Always, always thank the Holy Spirit every time He helps you to solve one or two issues or in anything He helps you with.
Great, Lady Loretta, we're making progress. We're making progress. Now, to the fifth question, it says, "People do not believe me when I tell them that the Holy Spirit told me to do something. What should I do?"
The Bible has already said that the world cannot know the Holy Spirit or receive the Holy Spirit. So you do not go about saying, "The Holy Spirit asked me to do this, the Holy Spirit asked me to do that," because they don't even know Him and they haven't received Him like you have. So just keep obeying the Holy Spirit and just see how your life turns around. It is they that will ask you, "What's your secret?" And then you can now tell them, "Oh, it's the Holy Spirit that helped me. It's the Holy Spirit that guided me. It's the Holy Spirit that inspired me." Then, because they see that it's really working, because they see that it's really true what you're talking about, they will now believe you and even make a decision to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. It's just that simple.
Okay, that's great. They don't have to announce to people what the Holy Spirit...
They
don't need to inform people that the Holy Spirit told me to do this. Let the results of the guidance of the Holy Spirit speak. That's...
Okay, now it's question number 6 and a very interesting one. And it says, "Can I speak in tongues at my age?"
Oh, yes. Yes, yes, you can. You can speak in tongues at your age. There's a story in the book of Acts. It's about a man, Cornelius. He had been instructed by an angel of God to send for Peter. And Peter came and he preached the word of God to him and his entire family. He even gathered other relations, not just his immediate family. So they were gathered, adults and children. They all gathered to listen to what Peter was teaching. And if we look at that verse, let's take a look at it. It's in Acts chapter 10, we'll look at verse 44 and 46. Verse 44 says, "Even as Peter was saying these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the message. And those that were with Peter were shocked." Verse 46 reads, "For they heard them speaking in other tongues and praising God." So once you believe in the Lord Jesus and you have the faith to receive the Holy Spirit as the message is being preached, or a servant of God lays his hands on you can receive the gift of speaking in tongues. If you really desire it, and pray about it. The Holy Spirit in you will lead you and guide you.
Okay, so you are not too young to speak in tongues. Don't forget that. Just ask the Holy Spirit to help you and He will be right there.
All right, to the next question. Of what use is speaking in tongues since I don't understand what I am saying?
Wow. Speaking in tongues is a language of the Spirit.
Okay.
It is God's coded love language with each of His children.
Wow.
Everyone has, yes, it's coded. Everyone has a unique. It's coded, like all those coding things. If you don't
it's a coded language between one person and God.
Between you and God.
That's beautiful.
So when you speak in tongues, you speak God's perfect will for your life.
Great.
It's perfect. You can't get it wrong with speaking in tongues. In other words, when you speak in tongues, you cannot pray a wrong prayer. You are praying the perfect prayer over your life. There is this scripture, I would like us to read it. Romans chapter 8, verse 26 to 28. It says, quickly, and the Holy Spirit helps us in our weakness. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for, but the Holy Spirit prays for us with groanings that cannot be expressed in words.
Wow.
And the Father who knows all hearts knows what the Spirit is saying. For the Spirit pleads for us believers in harmony with God's own will. And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to His purpose.
Great.
So, it makes it very clear, that scripture makes it clear that when you speak in tongues, all things work together for your good. So when you speak in tongues, only God understands what you are saying. Even you don't understand. God is all wise and He knows that is the only way He can get His children to pray His will for them.
Great.
So if God understands that, so whatever you say doesn't matter, okay? So long as it aligns with His will for your life. Another reason God gave us the gift of tongues is so that we can pray about our future. Mm-hmm. Paul wrote that speaking in tongues is a mystery and that your future too is a mystery. Your future too is a mystery. So with the gift of tongues, we can speak and pray heaven's best for our lives.
Okay, so if I'm getting you clearly, you're saying that when we speak in tongues, that tongues is a special language between the individual and God. That's one. Then secondly, it's a way they can pray the actual specific will of God for their lives.
Exactly.
And it helps to align the future, because since the future is a mystery, the tongues is also
a
language of mystery, so it aligns their future with the will of God.
And God is all wise too.
Beautiful. And so in addition, you know, someone may be wondering, how long should I speak in tongues?
That's speaking in tongues should be something we do all the time. Take time to speak in tongues. Wherever you are in the morning, 30 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, however the Spirit leads you. Take time to speak in tongues. Wherever you are, in class, at home, in the morning, whatever time.
So there isn't a specific length of time that we can speak in tongues?
No.
No.
Just take time. Just take your time.
So if it's for 10 minutes, 5 minutes,
5 minutes, 1 hour,
1 hour,
2 hours,
anywhere, in the bathroom, in the kitchen,
yes.
When I'm about to study, when I'm hanging out with friends. Okay, so I think I like that kind of friend.
Yeah, you speak in tongues with.
We have a coded language.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Very coded.
All right. Wow, I can bet you after today's session, there is nothing else you need more than the Holy Spirit. You sure do need Him. There is no one. You will never find anyone as reliable as the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And now to our memory verse. Our memory verse is taken from 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. And it says, everything in the scriptures is God's word. All of it is useful for teaching and helping people and for correcting them and showing them how to live. Okay, Leduce, you help us with this one. Question number eight. Does the Holy Spirit play any role when I read the Bible?
The Holy Spirit plays a lot of roles. In fact, there are so many roles the Holy Spirit plays, but I'll try to touch on a few of them. Number one, the Holy Spirit acts as a teacher. By teacher, what I mean is He helps you to understand the scripture you are reading. When you're studying the Bible, He will help you to relate God's word to your life situation. You know, He helps you to understand what you're reading. You know how a teacher, there's a topic, you've gone in school, you've gone home, you've read about the topic, but there are certain things you don't understand. And your teacher now takes time to explain it and clarify the things you don't understand. That's what the Holy Spirit does for you. He's a teacher.
Wow.
Then secondly, He's a guide. The Holy Spirit will help you to relate one scripture with another one. He helps you to put the scriptures together so you're not confused. He helps bring the Bible together. It's not like there are different stories that are contradictory. You know, He helps you see the big picture of what the Bible is talking about. Then thirdly, the Holy Spirit, when you read the Bible, the Holy Spirit reminds you. You know, the Bible is quite vast. There are a lot of verses in it. And you do your best to memorize as much as you can. But there are certain times, certain situations, you may not remember certain things. But as long as you've read it, the Holy Spirit will bring it to your remembrance. You may not know the exact verses word for word, but you're able to hold on to that verse because you know it's inside of you. You've read it. It's familiar to you. So He brings it up to your remembrance. Then another thing the Holy Spirit does is that if there are any, you know, when we read certain books, they are very interesting. And sometimes it may feel like the Bible is boring. But the Holy Spirit helps to make it interesting. He brings those things we are reading in the Bible. They come alive. You're able to picture it. You're able to imagine them. It becomes more real to you. That's what the Holy Spirit helps us to do. It helps when we're reading the Bible. And another thing, let me just say, a final thing He does for us is He helps to prepare our spirit, our minds, to receive the truth from the Word of God. You know, when you ask Him, you pray, you ask Him for His help before you read the Bible, He prepares your spirit to receive the truth in the Bible. He helps us to expand on this study. When we're doing a study in the Word of God, he makes us to, you know, we want to dig in more, we want to find out more things concerning any topic, whatever topic it is. When we ask the Holy Spirit for guidance, when we ask him before we start reading that topic, reading the Bible concerning that topic, the Holy Spirit helps us to find more truths. He helps with that study.
Wow, I can bet you after this session, you need the Holy Spirit. Before you begin reading the Word of God, before you pray, you need the Holy Spirit.
Wow, what an insightful session we have had today.
Yeah.
Did you send in questions? If you didn't, please, 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 we encourage you, send in your questions. Whatever topic, whatever issue bothers you, we would love to take the time in this platform to answer your questions. It doesn't necessarily have to be about the topic for the month. Whatever topic bothers you, whatever topic, please send in that topic to the numbers that are showing on your screen. Send your questions to them and we will take the time to answer your questions. Please follow us on our YouTube channel and our Telegram channel. You can download the Royal Scroll from the link showing on your screen. Goodbye, Royal. Go and conquer your world in Jesus' name. Amen.